In this lesson, we will see together les figures de style, but more precisely, we will see la prosopopée. So the first thing that we should define is les figures de style. What are we talking about? In the French language, as in any language, there are numerous figures of style, also known as figures de style or figures de rhétorique. These figures of speech are used to enhance the expressiveness, imagery, and impact of language in both spoken and written communication. These figures of style are used by writers and speakers to add depth, imagery, emphasis, and rhetorical flair to their language. And it makes their expressions more engaging and memorable. So, this lesson is about la prosopopée. Prosopopia is a rhetorical device that involves giving human characteristics or attributes to non-human entities, objects, or abstract concepts. Personification is often used in literature and poetry to make descriptions more vivid and relatable by attributing human traits to inanimate objects or natural phenomena. It helps create a deeper emotional connection between the reader or listener and the subject being personified. So let's see some examples with la prosopopée. Le vent souffle fort et les arbres murmurent leurs secrets. Le vent souffle fort et les arbres murmurent leurs secrets. La rivière chante sa mélodie apaisante à ceux qui l'écoutent. La rivière chante sa mélodie apaisante à ceux qui l'écoutent. La lune veille silencieusement sur la terre endormie. La lune veille silencieusement sur la terre endormie. Les étoiles scintillent dans le ciel, témoins de l'immensité de l'univers. Les étoiles scintillent dans le ciel, témoins de l'immensité de l'univers. Les vagues de l'océan racontent leurs aventures au sable de la plage. Les vagues de l'océan racontent leurs aventures au sable de la plage. La montagne majestueuse défie le ciel de sa grandeur imposante. La montagne majestueuse défie le ciel de sa grandeur imposante.